Assalamu alaikum guys, hi, this is Muhammad Saqib Khan from HPGS and the topic today we are going to cover is current electricity. Right guys, let me start the learning outcomes of the day. The first is current and the second learning outcome is the electromotive force and the third one is potential difference and the last one is the resistance. Let me start the very first topic. This is actually current. Okay guys, when we talk about the concept of the concept of the current is flow of charges while when we talk about the definition of the current is the rate of flow of charges, the rate of flow of charges. So on the basis of the definition, we have current is equal to charges upon time. Right guys, the current will be equal to I, charges represented by Q and time represented by the T. So now first of all, when we talk about the current, the concept of the current is the flow of charges, while the definition of the current is the rate of flow of charges, and the formula of the current will become current is equal to charge upon time. Now guys, we can easily be describe this formula by the help of a triangular formula. Triangular formula gives you the help for the numerical types of question. For example, you want to calculate the current from any equation, you just hide the value of I and the formula will become Q upon T. In second case, if you want to calculate the charges from the formula, it will become I into T, and similarly if you hide the T, it will become Q upon I. Now if you go for the more elaboration of the current, we have a simple diagram. For example, we say that in a cross-sectional wire, if we zoom this wire, what will we notice? That there are a lot of charges or the free ions inside the wire. What will happen? Actually, the current is how many number of charges passing through in a cross-sectional area in 1 second. Now this is the simplest definition, the rate of the flow of charges. While in this case we can say that, or in other words, हमारे पास एक और definition भी आ सकती है current की, और वही हो सकती है the number of charges passing through a cross sectional area in 1 second. Now the next point will become the SI unit of current is ampere, and very next point will become the ammeter is used to measure the current in a circuit. Okay guys, if you go for the next point, we have two different types of current. Why? Because we have two different type of charges, positive charge as well as negative charge. On the basis of this, we say that we have two types of current. The first type of current is conventional current. Conventional current. Let me start. What is conventional current? Actually, conventional current is the current which is produced due to flow of positive charges. So very first point will become produced due to flow of positive charges, due to flow of positive charges, while the direction of this current is in the circuit is from positive terminal to the negative terminal. Right guys, for example, we have a circuit, a very small circuit for you people. So now this is the current which actually flow in a circuit from positive terminal of the battery to the negative terminal of the battery. After this, we have the second type of current, दिस इज एक्चुअली अ इलेक्ट्रॉनिक करंट. दिस इलेक्ट्रॉनिक करंट इज प्रोड्यूस ड्यू टू फ्लो ऑफ नेगेटिव चार्जेस. फ्लो ऑफ नेगेटिव चार्जेस एंड द डायरेक्शन ऑफ दिस करंट विल बी फ्रॉम द अपोजिट डायरेक्शन ऑफ द कन्वेंशनल करंट. For example, when we talk about the conventional current, it must flow in this direction. While when we talk about the electronic current, it will be flow from negative terminal of the battery to the positive terminal of the battery. Now come to the next point. After the completion of the types of current, we use two terminologies of the current. We have two terminologies of current. We use two terminologies to describe the current. The number one is alternating current, shortly it is called AC. Alternating current. And the second terminology is DC current, which is actually a direct current. Let me start one by one to describe these two terminologies, guys. The first one is the alternating current. Shortly, it is called AC current. Guys, it's a sinusoidal current. Sinusoidal current, it means it changes its direction several times in a circuit in 1 second. सो साइनोसोइडल करंट वो करंट है हमारे पास जो अपनी डायरेक्शन को चेंज कर रहा है. इट चेंज इज डायरेक्शन सेवरल टाइम. इट मीन्स दैट इट मूव्स इन अ पॉजिटिव वे एज वेल एज इन अ नेगेटिव वे. सो दिस इज कॉल्ड ऑल्टरनेटिंग करंट. एंड दिस ऑल्टरनेटिंग करंट नॉर्मली वी यूज इन आर डेली लाइफ. फॉर एग्जाम्पल वी यूज इन आर होम अप्लाइंसिस. एंड द सेकेंड सो type of current is the DC current, which is actually a shortly direct current. DC current, guys, DC current is a unidirectional current. It's a unidirectional current. What means? It means it only flow in one direction. It won't be change its direction in different way. It's not going in a positive and negative, but it's only flow in single direction. That is why it is called unidirectional current. And the main source of this current is cells and batteries. Okay, guys, after the completion of these two terminologies of the current, we are going to start our next topic. This is actually electromotive force. So let me start the electromotive force. Guys, electromotive force is a shortly it is called EMF. Now, what is the electromotive force? The very first thing, the concept of the electromotive force is a energy supply. What does it mean? It means it provides the energy supplier. It provides the energy in the whole circuit. How? just before the elaboration of this point, we need to define the electromotive force. The definition of the electromotive force is the work done required to drive a unit charge. The work done required to drive a unit charge in the whole circuit. I'm not going to write down the complete definition of the board because it will take long time. I'm just going to write down the very simple, the work done required to drive a unit charge throughout the circuit. What does it mean? It means that EMF is equal to work done upon charges or energy upon charges. इन सिंपल लैंग्वेज भी हम ये कह सकते हैं कि आपका जो सर्किट होता है उस सर्किट को बड़ा चार्जेस ऑलरेडी प्रेजेंट इन साइड द वायर. इफ वी ज़ूम दिस वायर तो चार्ज इज ऑलरेडी इन साइड द वायर बट दिस चार्ज डू नॉट हैव इनफ एनर्जी टू मूव इन द होल सर्किट. सो एक्चुअली our electromotive force provide the energy or supply the energy to discharge to move in the whole circuit. The second thing, after the completion of the electromotive force, we say that the SI unit of the charge is SI unit of EMF is volt. And voltmeter is used. Voltmeter is used to measure the EMF in the circuit. Now, how? For example, we want to calculate the EMF of this circuit. So we have to connect our voltmeter across the terminal of the battery. Now, this is the position of the voltmeter to measure the EMF of the battery. So actually we conclude the three things in the EMF. The first is the concept, it's an energy supplier. The second thing is the definition, the work done required to drive a unit charge in the whole circuit. And the formula of related to the definition is E is equal to W upon Q or E upon Q. Now come to the very next point. Guys, humne ye kaha ki charges are already present inside the wires. But they do not have enough energy to move in the whole circuit. So actually hamara EMF kya karega? It provides the energy to this charge to move in the whole circuit. Right guys? Then we have the SI unit of the charge is SI unit of the EMF is volt, and the voltmeter is used to measure the EMF of the circuit. How? We have to connect the voltmeter across the terminal of the battery to measure the EMF of the circuit. After this point, we go for our next point. This is the potential difference. Potential difference. Potential difference. And another name of the potential difference is voltage, and shortly we call this is PD in some way. So let me start the concept of the potential difference. The concept of the PD is its energy consumer, energy utilizer or energy consumer or utilizer. How? To understand this thing, we need to define the potential difference. The definition of the potential difference is the work done required, to drive a unit charge in the component. Now what's happened? यहाँ पे जब हमने बात की थी तो ये जो हमारा चार्ज था इस चार्ज को जो एनर्जी चाहिए थी पूरे सर्किट में रोटेट करने के लिए चाहिए थी, जबकि व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट द पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस, सो पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस इज रिक्वायर्ड टू ओनली ड्राइव दिस चार्ज इनसाइड द कंपोनेंट। तो हम सिर्फ ये देखेंगे कि हमारा कितना वर्क डन रिक्वायर्ड है इस कंपोनेंट में से पास होने के लिए, राइट गाइस। तो फॉर एग्जांपल अगर हम इसकी बात करें तो पोटेंशियल हमारे पास दोबारा से वही फार्मूला आएगा, W अपॉन क्यू और एनर्जी अपॉन क्यू। अगेन द SI यूनिट ऑफ पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस इज ऑल्सो वोल्ट, बट एट दिस टाइम ऑल्दो वी यूज अगेन द वोल्ट मीटर टू मेजर द पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस, बट एट दिस टाइम द पोजिशन ऑफ द वोल्ट मीटर हैज बीन चेंज्ड, वी यूज द पोटेंशियल वोल्ट मीटर अक्रॉस द टर्मिनल ऑफ द कंपोनेंट। नाउ दिस इज द सिंपल पोजिशन। अगर हमारे पास EMF यहाँ पे वोल्ट मीटर लगा हुआ है, इट गिव्स यू द EMF, एंड इफ यू कनेक्टेड द वोल्ट मीटर अक्रॉस द टर्मिनल ऑफ द कंपोनेंट, एक्चुअली राइट नाउ आई एम यूजिंग द लैम्प, तो एट दिस टाइम द वोल्ट मीटर गिव्स यू द पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस ऑफ दिस सर्किट। नाउ दिस इज द सिंपल रिव्यू ऑफ द पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस कॉन्सेप्ट, इट्स एनर्जी सप्लायर और यूटिलाइजर और एनर्जी कंज्यूमर। व्हाट हैपेंड एक्चुअली, द एनर्जी विच इज प्रोवाइडेड बाय दिस चार्ज फ्रॉम द सेल, तो ये हमारा जो एनर्जी चार्ज लेकर आएगा आपका ये कंपोनेंट उस एनर्जी को यूज करेगा। सिर्फ एग्जांपल हमने ये कहा, वी हैव अ 6 वोल्ट बैटरी। अब ये 6 वोल्ट की जो हमारी बैटरी है, इट प्रोवाइड 6 जूल एनर्जी टू दिस चार्ज, एंड दिस चार्ज इज मूव इन द होल सर्किट, बट व्हेन इट रीच एट दिस कंपोनेंट, जो कि हमारा राइट नाउ क्या लगा हुआ है, बल्ब लगा हुआ है, तो इस बल्ब में जब ये हमारे पास पहुंचेगा, हम ये कहेंगे द रिक्वायरमेंट ऑफ दिस बल्ब इज 4 वोल्ट। नाउ व्हाट विल बी द पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस, 6 वोल्ट एनर्जी प्रोवाइडेड बाय द सेल व्हिच इज एक्चुअली एन EMF, एंड चार्ज स्टार्ट टू मूव, एंड व्हेन इट एंटर इनटू द कंपोनेंट 4 वोल्ट एनर्जी इज यूटिलाइज्ड। सो देयर विल बी अ डिफरेंस क्रिएट बिटवीन द EMF एंड द पोटेंशियल एंड द कंजम्पशन एनर्जी ऑफ दिस कंपोनेंट। तो जिस कंपोनेंट ने जितना एनर्जी को यूज कर लिया, जितना कंज्यूम कर लिया, ये हमारा पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस क्रिएट करेगा, और एंड इट इज कॉल्ड द पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस ऑफ दिस सर्किट इज 4 वोल्ट। सो व्हाट विल हैपन व्हेन चार्ज एंटर इन दिस कंपोनेंट, इट हैज 6 वोल्ट, इन अदर वर्ड्स इट हैज 6 जूल एनर्जी, बट व्हेन इट लीव्स आउट फ्रॉम दिस सर्किट और फ्रॉम दिस कंपोनेंट, इट हैज ओनली 2 वोल्ट remaining. Why? Because the 4 volt is the consumption of this component. In other words, हम ये कह सकते हैं कि हमारे बल्ब ने वो जो 6 जूल वोल्ट की एनर्जी थी उसमें से 4 वोल्ट को कंज्यूम कर लिया और बकाए के 2 वोल्ट को दोबारा से बैटरी के पास भेज दिया। अब ये हमारा चार्ज दोबारा से बैटरी के पास आएगा एंड इट अगेन फिल विद द 6 वोल्ट, एंड इन अदर टर्म इट अगेन फिल्ड बाय द 6 जूल एनर्जी एंड अगेन मूव इन साइड द होल सर्किट गाइस। एंड आफ्टर दिस द पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट द रेजिस्टेंस। Resistance, right guys? Again we start the resistance by the concept, from the concept. The concept of the resistance is hindrance or obstacle. What does it mean? It means when charges are trying to flow inside the wire, it's an hindrance produced inside the wire or inside the circuit which is not allowed to charges or electron to move freely inside the circuit. That is why it's an hindrance. So the definition of the resistance is the ratio between voltage and current. Simply we can say that resistance actually the ratio between voltage and current And finally, R is equal to V upon I. Again, we are going to make another triangular formula for this. Right, guys? And we have the same analogy just like in current we use. If we want to calculate the current, we have to hide the value of R. It gives the formula V upon I. Or agar hame value of I chahiye, to we have to hide the value of I. It gives you the formula V upon R. Now, come to the next point. The SI unit of the the SI unit of the resistance is ohm. Okay, guys. Now come to the next point. After the completion of the resistance, we have resistor. Now, first of all, we have to differentiate between the resistance and resistor. Actually, resistance is a characteristic which is already present inside the different material or inside the different nature of material. Why resistor is a device or component? They are the component which is used to control the size of current, to control the size of current. Kya matlab? It means hum resistor ko system mein khud lagate hain taaki current ke flow ko control kar sakein. The first thing, how? Ab is baat ko samajhne ke liye hame do baaton ko samajhna padega. The relationship between resistance and current. Actually, it's inversely proportional with each other. Means, if we put a resistor which have a larger value, for example, I have a wire and the charges are flow from this wire in this direction. Now what will happen? Charges are can easily be flow if we provide a complete path. But let's suppose if I put an obstacle at this position in the form of resistance, what will happen? At this time, almost half of the charges cannot pass through from this part. इट मीन्स कि हमने एक रेजिस्टर लगा के चार्जेस को या इलेक्ट्रॉन्स के पाथ को कम कर दिया. अब इसके कम करने की वजह से हमारे पास जो फ्लो ऑफ करंट था वो कम हो गया. सिमिलरली अगर हम इसी पॉइंट को थोड़ा सा और बढ़ा देंगे, इट मीन्स हमने ऑब्स्टिकल को, वी हैव टू इंक्रीज द ऑब्स्टिकल फर्दर मोर. नाउ यू विल बी नोटिस दैट द पाथ विल बी ऑल्सो रिड्यूस टू फ्लो फॉर इलेक्ट्रॉन और चार्जेस टू मूव. So actually it's an obstacle which we provide in the circuit, right, guys? Now after the completion of the resistor, we have two types of resistor. Two types. The number one is the fixed resistor and number two is the variable resistor. Variable resistor. Fixed resistor have the fixed value and variable resistor have the value varies. Okay, guys, we have two types of resistor. The first one is a fixed resistor and the second is a variable resistor. This is also called rheostat. It means the value of this resistor is the fixed value. We cannot change the value of this resistor. Why? While the variable resistor can vary its value according to our need. Now this is the simple topic we have to conclude from current, electromagnetic force, potential difference and resistor. Thank you very much.